Okay, looks like we're on episode 71 now, I think. What am I doing here? Exploring, going out of this one. Space around Ike. Surface of Eve. Okay. So yeah, I did want to send the radiation ship over to Eve to pick up the lab there and bring it home. Ultimately, I want to send it to the outer planets, but for now, I just want to pick it up and move it back to, I guess, Kerbal. I guess we can refit it. I don't know if there's much I want to change on it, but well, that's the main goal there. And while I'm there, I think I can try and drop a probe onto Eve. Oh, that could be tricky, and to do it for 17,000 seems like not a lot, but anyway. Hopefully I can get some more. Maybe I should go to Duna first. By Ike, fly by Nimbus, fly by Eve. The other possibility is I wonder if I could take like a small kind of probe-like ship, attach it to the radiation, just carry it with me, because I will eventually go back to Ike as well. I don't know what counts. I'm gonna be doing that one. But this is certainly possible. I think I'm going to take that one. Tutorial on the bike. Orbital station, pointless, not doing this on the surface, light a flag on Duna. Suppose I could do that. What I need is, I'm hoping that if I create just a small ship with a, you know, basically like a little probe kind of thing, very light, I'm hoping that if you just take a probe core, basically this, if I were to launch this, and then carry it around to those four locations, that I would solve that one particular mission, right, to hit those four planets. Where's the same way? 0.1, 0.04. This way is the lightest, so I'll take one of these. So I think I'll just make I guess I could make it a little lander. Just wonder if I have anything already landed on Ike. Maybe I could drop something down to do surface I don't think I have anything on Ike other than the lab. Kerbin, Ike. I have this guy orbiting Ike. This guy landed on Ike. Yeah, so I don't have anything landed. I won't have anything landed. I think I'm going to take the. I'm kind of tired of driving that thing around on Ike, so I'm just going to. I think I'm just going to remove that lab from Ike. Although maybe some sort of surface scanning thing might be useful around Ike, if I have such a thing. Science. Survey scanner. Mission of the planet. Tower modes, natural resources. These images can be viewed through. I don't know if this gives you the biomes. I think this just tells you where you can get resources. This is kind of interesting. Maybe I should be putting these on my labs as well. Log observation data. Well, this is interesting. I wonder if I could use this to make remote observations around other, you know, around moons and stuff without having a pilot there. It's an interesting idea. Well, it's huge. That is one large space-based telescope. How much does this thing weigh? 0.1 doesn't weigh too much. Battery. Pull those on there. And a solar panel there. It's kind of pointless, actually. You really want over here. Be enough here. So this kind of thing, and a docking. That. Can this be put in a cargo hold? I should just build it on top of the... For a telescope. Let's say that it can't. It's not here, so I'm thinking no, this thing cannot fit in there, which I guess makes sense because this does look bigger than that. So we gotta launch it, and save this thing as a sub-assembly. Alright, well, it's not too difficult to build again. What else was I going to do? I don't know. Let me just throw it on top of a tanker, I guess. Maybe I should just make a ship to take this thing up. So this thing I want to stick on the on there. Also need some communications as well. Let's get an antenna up here. Massive relay antenna. That's nice. That isn't causing any problems. Literally massive relay antenna. The chances that this thing's gonna. It'd be a fun thing to launch. this thing is so lopsided over here. So it's going to go to the top, but it kind of clips into the hood here. Just all kinds of bad. I'll give you a relay ability. Assuming I can launch this thing. Engine on here. There's a few things going on here. An engine of some sort, please. You know, it's a trusty swivel. Get enough thrust to make this happen. Theoretically, that's enough to get us into orbit. Observation relay. You know, what else you want to do, obviously, is put these guys on. Because theoretically, assuming this guy can do an observation, these guys will be able to do the other orbital experiments you want to do, to do those contracts. If this thing works, I should leave this thing around Eve, or around Gilly to be more precise. Oh my goodness, there's so much stuff. I don't know, it's difficult to keep track of all the things I have to do here, but the other thing I wanted to do, obviously, is take. I'm just going to save this. I don't think I want to take this because I have to go to Eve. I have to take a ship that I can take to Eve and take to the other locations. I also want to take something to land on Eve, right? And it's obviously ain't that. So I think I need something completely different here. Where's my. In order to land on Eve, I'm going to need a whole bunch of relay probes. I'm going to have her on Kerbin. What is this? Comnet HG5. This kind of thing. that is garbage. One of these things, as I had before, I will take a one of these on it. Power battery on it. So we have this thing here. Junior. So, so this little section here will be the thing that I carry around, I guess. These guys all deploy when I get there. That makes sense. I'll just go and stick this thing on the that's how it fits. Okay, so that so this thing here, the bottom part, will go with me to all the locations. These guys I'll stick in orbit around Eve to help me with the landing. Then I will need another docking port. Then, well, yeah, then there's going to be an actual lander here. Work. I'm going to have to put it on the other end. But, I have to put another clamp control on there and then this thing. I think that will decouple. Then on here, we're gonna, let's just fill this with science experiments. That guy. Actually even reach the just throw another couple of them in there. Just so I can get to that clapperdron to hopefully so there's that. Then there is, what else do we need here? I just really don't like the way that's joined up there. I could put them on the top, but that's going to make it, it's going to be super spindly. Well, maybe it would work. I don't know if I put enough struts on it. Build it from the other direction. Let me just try building it from this way. That's kind of what I want, is that. Well, I guess we could just have to put struts on here. Ichio, please. So what's my doing here? What else needs to go on this thing? Obviously a probe core of some sort. And I need a sort of battery. Maybe a larger battery for a second on that one. We're gonna need a one of these guys on there. Those guys. And these guys. That. of those guys on there. Want to need an antenna. We should take another antenna for the parachute, if we get a parachute. A parachute, antennas, I see we need more experiments. Atmospheric variometer. So that's good. I think it will just drop and they'll just land on the ground. If he lands slowly enough, it should be okay. He's pretty light, so that one parachute should be enough. I think. Put another antenna on him. The other one will be unavailable while he's descending. This guy does not need full lead later. This guy probably needs less than full lead later. I think it's pretty light. I don't think I need legs. I think I'm good there. Okay, so that's the idea. So this thing is going to attach to the top of the thing, to the radiation. This thing will drop into the atmosphere. These guys will spread around the planet for communication, the relay. These are only to be used on the ground, so I'm going to put some other. Here's the. I'm going to put some of these guys on here. Just for basically while I'm in orbit and descent. Of course, I have no engines on here, so we should probably do something about that too. Just trying to think of how this is going to go. Yeah, I guess I could just carry this guy down with me. Engines. way more engine than I need. Wonder if maybe I should be just using Oscar V on this thing. Meters per second. I guess if we're in low orbit, that should be plenty, right? I'll call this. Lander complex. So that's that. I think that'll work, right? So basically, I drop this guy into a lowish orbit. Then I start popping these other guys around some other orbit. This thing stays on the ship until we complete the entire four celestial object mission. This guy stays there, so he comes back with us and he goes back up to Ike or Duna or whatever it is. I think that's what we're doing. I think this thing will make it to the ground. I'm going to pop these things. We got the chute on there. 116 meters per second should be enough to get us from a low orbit into the atmosphere. And from there, you know, atmospheric friction will do the rest for me, and the parachute will land me. At least that's the plan. How this thing is sitting there. Looks like it's kind of hovering above it, but I guess that's the way it sits. So now I need some sort of rocket to take this hunk of junk into the orbit. Don't think I'm going to need any solar panels on this one, to be perfectly honest. I really don't, but maybe I should. Anyway. Meh. I don't think so. I think it's going to come up. Need something to deliver this thing, so. What is that going to be? Docking port there. Fuel tanks, please. I guess we should do the missile cylinders. I suppose a swivel will take care of this. Not quite, This is going to be spindly in the extreme, so we need struts here. I wonder if I should just use a larger format. Just so I can get some more leverage on the struts. Does not want to attach anything to the heat shield. It's kind of attached. Teaching is like crazy, but anyway, '64, and then '44. I guess I could turn the torque off on all of these guys. Which maybe will help with I'm gonna put some solar panels in this thing. There's no sense having reaction wheels on it. Well, maybe I don't need a battery or reaction wheels on this thing. Maybe I just need the probe core, because that's the only thing that I need to take around. What do you think about that? Guys, not quite. Save that. Need a massive reaction wheel in here. I guess we have a fair amount of power up here on the stack. Well, we should pretty much just throw some more batteries in this thing? Later, so I can deorbit this thing. So I think that's the deal. 4,400 should be plenty to get into orbit, but the only question is this thing going to be so bendy and basically noodling in this huge air brake on the top? Oh, that's going to cause problems for me. Hard to say. $74,000. Pretty expensive. If there's a better way of doing this, probably there is. That's really expensive. Probably the top is 40. This is going to be a very big disaster if this crashes. So let's try going up slowly. Do I have enough? Yeah, I think I should be okay as far as control goes. It's very spindly to me. Get to around 200. 35,000. Yeah, we haven't enough. No, that's disappointing. Oh dear. Oh dear. Okay, so maybe I can save the lander guy here. So, we don't have that. We burned off all of the fuel on the Oscar B as well. Okay, maybe I can land him and. Save a bit of money that way. This guy all around with this. We can land the whole thing. Maybe. It's too heavy, we'll drop all the heat shields off and stuff. So I didn't believe it need more than 4,400 to get into orbit. But. maybe I should go with the solid fuels, get rid of the mainsail, go with a solid fuel and maybe a kind of a lighter upper stage. That might feel cheaper and might give us more delta V. Although it's not as controllable as far as speed on the way up, though, so that's problematic. Maybe just a little solid fuel booster off the gate. Maybe go up a little faster this time. This is too fast. Disturbing. Right. Crazy to have 4400 delta V and be considering so what am I going to do here? I turn cross feed off, first of all. So that. I guess I'm going to add some boosters. This is crazy, but ~5,000 delta V. ~44 to ~46. That's 200 more delta V. Much really. this has a 500. So, I mean, goodness gracious, if this doesn't do it, I don't know what will. Why not? More struts. Why not? This goes to weight ratio 2. So we're basically going to throttle back like mad, let the solid fuels go as far as they can go, and then we're going to. This is crazy expensive, but then we're going to use the rest to achieve orbit with this thing. Crazy. All right, there's another 80,000 down the hole. I have to be very careful with the speed on this one. Staging's a bit weird here. Disastrous. Didn't flip yet, that's. Looks like SAS isn't on. That's how wobbly it is. No. No. Just can't seem to. Three. We're gonna make it into orbit, so that's something. After this, I was like, the most disturbing, launch ever. Barely make it into orbit. Or if you're about to deorbiting this thing is going to be a bit of a trick, but anyway, you may not be able to do that. That booster will have to sit there for a while, I think. Oh, it is. Maybe it's useful, huh? Well, that's 500 meters per second here. I guess we can raise the orbit. Like that. So we have this basically big engine with there's no probe core on here. Not sure what to do with this. Maybe I should bring this. Yeah, who else? Right. So I think I'm just going to leave this thing out here as debris, and I can deal with it later. You know, I can probably add a probe core to it later if I want to repurpose it for some reason, or maybe harvest things off of it and then throw the rest into the or into the atmosphere. So now what I need to do is, I guess, send the radiation ship over to pick up all this stuff. Actually, just need to go and get a map view. Does this guy have? I'm not seeing any RCS. Oh, yeah, it does have RCS ports on here. Okay, good. So I should be able to dock this thing. It's me, space dock. That. Oh, whoa. Let's correct my plane of my orbit first before all this. Okay.
We know me.
What the heck? Let's do this silly thing again. I can right fly, that's fine, but if mechjeb does it. Well, that's a problem. Oops. We're not flying properly here. It's getting worse. What the heck is going on here? Oh, what a disaster. I do that so many times. It's like the wrong control point. You end up, totally messing everything around. Try that again. I'm gonna have to refuel this thing one more time. God. I guess I can steal a liquid fuel from this other behemoth, but that stuttering thing is trying to tell you that it's on the wrong, it's going the wrong direction or something. I don't know. Separation zero. Velocities. Pretty accurate. It's coming right in on me. Trying to line this thing out. I can't. Total torque. Okay. Let's get rid of this. That. Come from here. Oops. That.
Dragon.
If I'll be able to attach struts here or not, whether it's going to be a real problem, because this is like a noodle on the top of this thing with a big dumbbell weight on the end of it. So ideally I would attach some struts down to this thing to keep it stiff. I think I've got some struts around here on the space dock that I could run over there. There are some struts here. Should be enough. So I'll take this with, I'm not sure whether there's any the guys in the other ship have any sort of EVA abilities, or whether that was removed once the upgrade happened. So I'll take that with me. Got a fair amount of fuel here. Oh, maybe I can. Wish I had a probe core. Should I take some of these? I think so. Maybe I should bring him a probe core. Obviously some fuel would be good too. Maybe I'll just run up a probe core. See if I can attach that to the other, to that piece of junk there. In case I want to deorbit it at some point. take those. It's going to need an antenna as well. Okay, let me just run up a probe core. Some fuel, that kind of stuff before this guy heads out. Running around low on funds here too with all these crazy things going on. This guy here, since we need a little bit of extra fuel too for the that, and okay, I'm gonna just get rid of these things here and put some probe cores on there. I need a grab. Array retrograde. Let's do the assist. 650, 450. And these hexes are better. So I'll put a couple of those on. Is there anything else that I want to take up there? Ports wise? I think so. I could carry some more of these probe cores. Why not? I don't know if there's anything else I would want to take with me. Can't think of anything. Maybe, some ability to store RCS on the station. Just throw a couple of those on there, and we'll just take them off and stick them on the station. When we get up there, I assume we can do that. And say I can't. Let me just to be clear here. Can't look at that, only the small ones. That's strange. So I could take this one here, which holds 120. I can't take this one here, which holds 50. Yeah. doesn't make any sense at all. Unfortunate. Okay, so that is that. Should I throw some antennas on there as well? Sure, let's take a couple antennas up too. What else? I guess that's it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think that's it. Yeah, I can't think of anything else that I want to send up there. Oh, maybe some cargo. Is there a cargo hold in this thing? There's no cargo hold in this thing at all. Can I put a cargo hold on this thing? Quarters. Okay. All right, we're gonna need more space. Cargo. Is there anything else that I, oh yeah, I want to take some I want to take up some of these guys. Save this. I guess my question was, do the guys in the radiation ship have EVA jets or not? Or were they taken away? Oh yeah, so they have parachutes and RCS, okay, fair enough. Anyway, some might not, so maybe I'll just take some up anyway. Doesn't hurt to have them on hand, right? And some repair kits, because we probably need those as well at some point. That should be plenty, right? Like so. Let's just put these things back on. I don't know why, but. Okay, so we dock with this. Move the cargo over we need. Top up the tanks. Liquid fuel, anyway. That. Separation 0.6, that should be enough. Well, actually. Supposed to be 1.3 kilometers away, so that should be enough. But who knows? Do not want to crash into the space dock. And line it up. It's pretty close. Didn't work very well. works there. Okey-dokes. Shake itself to death here. So turn this off just in case. Okay, so we have storage units here. Roll the card over. What is it doing? Just a little bit about. Might have been better if these guys had been in here in the core as opposed to this far apart, but anyway, too late for that. So I don't need to bring this along. Yeah, I might have bring a couple of those. Don't need that. I bring some of these guys along, or one of them anyway. A probe core to attach, and that's about it, right? I mean, one of those guys? Yeah. It should be enough. Okay. It's got 1100 delta V. That should be enough to get there and get back. Those are 296. He's a little lower than me, so I'm gonna go a little higher, I guess, to get an orbit going. So prograde. You know, this guy doesn't have any. He has no solar panel. This could be problematic. Should be good enough. So here's that. I guess I'm closer. I probably should have brought it down so I catch up to him. That would have been a smarter move. But anyway. Too late now. We've spent the delta V. I'll just have to, you know, wait a lot longer. In 3 days. 3 days time. Okay, this one's going pretty long here. Trying to assemble all this. stuff in orbit. Might be easier just to build something on the planet, launch it, and go. Keep trying to save money by spending even more money. Where is it? I don't see it. Where is it? There it is. Hey. I think we're going to miss him, so... I don't have a lot of charge on this thing. Goodness gracious. And power. I need obviously more power. And then we sun couldn't come out at a better time. I think we needed more batteries in this thing. Oh my goodness gracious me. Well, it really burnt off a lot of fuel. Okay, so I think we got them all here. But I don't have really that much. I'm going to have to top it up again with another flight, I guess. So 41 left. It carries 360. So maybe I can do another flight out of this. Okay. Start broncoing here. Or... Let's turn the torque off on that guy. It's fairly stable. We're supposedly in the sunlight here, although you'd never know. Oh, here we are. Okay, so how are we going to do this here? It's quite long. I got to go all the way over here and attach things. If I can. Can you carry it, or how is that going to work? Maybe I just have to get my guy out there, but let's just try that. This thing here. Okay, so that looks like it's really strong. Much of these things on here. that sort of business. So what else did I have to... Yeah, the rest of this is for the other ship. Well, maybe these two guys here I can send over. So, cargo. Definitely don't need those parachutes. On there. The air kits in here. Although they're kind of useless without an engineer, aren't they? True that. Check the dia, which is also not need a parachute. Well, you know, the parachutes probably are useful on Duna in case of emergency, so maybe I'll just leave them on there. Okay, so that is that. How much does he have left here? I think there's enough fuel on board here. There's a fair amount of fuel. So what I'm looking for is debris. This thing here. Kilometers. Turn the torque back on here. Well, actually, I want to go backwards to catch up with him, right? Really. Orbit. Retrograde. One year. Ugh. Has it been 7 days? It seems like a Sorry. What is doing? Okay, let's match velocities. Man, this is a long day here. I'm gonna, almost 3 hours. I gotta quit here. This is crazy. I honestly don't know how I'm going to. This thing, but it's kind of poor placement of the solar panel in front of my light. Getting a little close here, we're just gonna unfortunately have to maneuver the whole thing in ourselves here. A little further than that, I think. What's going on here? Do I have no? Pretty close. Oh, is this a small one? Oh, it's a tiny one. These are not compatible. Can I just grab? Is batteries. While I'm here. So that was interesting. So maybe I just park next to it. That should be enough. Okay, 9 meters. Why is it immediately repel on me? I'm gonna need a different docking port though, I'll tell you that. Okay, well, I got some batteries on this thing anyways. I was able to grab batteries from it, but I couldn't grab the docking adapter from it. That's really unusual, I have to say. Well, that's something. Anyway, I think that's enough. I'm gonna break for the day here. Enough of this craziness.